Imagine driving from Germany to Denmark. Not over a bridge, not by ferry, but under the Baltic Sea. This isn't science fiction. It's the Fehmarnbelt Tunnel, one of the most ambitious infrastructure projects ever built in Europe. When completed, it will become the longest underwater tunnel in the world, stretching 18 kilometers between the German island of Fehmarn and the Danish island of Lolland. For decades, travelers relied on ferries to cross this stretch of sea, a trip that takes about 45 minutes and is often delayed by weather. The new tunnel will cut that to just 10 minutes by car or 7 minutes by train. It's not just a shortcut, it's a revolution in European connectivity. The Fehmarnbelt project is a crucial part of the trans-European transport network, connecting Scandinavia with Central Europe. Once finished, it will link Copenhagen and Hamburg in only 2.5 hours instead of 5. For freight trains, it will slash travel times and open a faster, greener corridor for goods moving between Northern and Southern Europe. But why a tunnel instead of a bridge? Early designs from the 1990s considered a massive suspension bridge. However, studies showed that strong winds, environmental concerns, and shipping routes in the Baltic made a tunnel safer and more efficient. So engineers decided on an immersed tube tunnel, a method where giant precast concrete sections are sunk and joined on the seabed, the same technique used for the Öresund tunnel between Denmark and Sweden, only on a far larger scale. The entire project is led by Femern AS, a Danish state-owned company. Construction officially began in 2020, and completion is planned for 2029. By then, this colossal structure will feature 2 road tunnels, 2 rail tunnels, and a central emergency passage, all beneath the Baltic Sea. This is more than a tunnel, it's a statement that even in an age of borders and climate anxiety, nations can still come together to build something that connects, inspires, and endures. Building the Fehmarnbelt Tunnel isn't just construction, it's choreography on a scale the world has rarely seen. At a purpose-built site near Rødbyhavn in Denmark, engineers have created one of the largest tunnel factories on Earth. Here, 89 enormous concrete elements, each around 217 meters long, 42 meters wide, and 9 meters high, are being cast in dry docks. Once completed, these massive hollow blocks are sealed, floated out to sea, and gently lowered into a trench on the seabed. Every movement must be perfect. Each element weighs about 73,000 tons, and when 2 of them meet, underwater, they must align with millimeter precision. GPS-guided cranes, divers, and remote-controlled vehicles ensure that the sections connect seamlessly. Once in place, they're sealed with giant rubber gaskets and reinforced with concrete, forming a watertight link that will endure for more than a century. This method, called the immersed tube technique, is proven but rarely attempted on this scale. To make it possible, the seabed beneath the Baltic has been dredged to create a perfectly leveled trench up to 16 meters deep and nearly 90 meters wide. Specialized dredgers remove sediment with minimal disturbance to the marine environment, while silt screens and sensors constantly monitor water quality. Inside the finished tunnel, travelers will find a 5-section layout, 2 lanes for cars in each direction, 2 tracks for electric trains, and a central service corridor for maintenance and emergencies. Cross passages connect the tubes every 100 meters, allowing people to evacuate safely if an incident occurs. Ventilation systems and jet fans control airflow, while smart lighting and fire suppression systems make this one of the safest tunnels ever designed. Despite these advancements, the challenges are enormous. Underwater currents, weather, and logistics can delay even the most precise operations. Germany's side of the project, in particular, faced years of legal hurdles and environmental reviews before receiving final approval. But once those obstacles were cleared, the construction phase accelerated rapidly. By late 2025, excavation, dredging, and element production are all in full swing. The first tunnel segments are expected to be immersed around 2026, setting the stage for the world's longest undersea connection to finally take shape beneath the Baltic Sea. Massive projects like the Fehmarnbelt Tunnel never come without controversy. The Baltic Sea is home to fragile ecosystems, from porpoises and cod to eelgrass meadows that shelter countless marine species, Environmental groups in both Denmark and Germany have long warned that dredging millions of cubic meters of seabed could disturb wildlife, stir up sediments, and damage these habitats. To counter this, the builders have implemented one of the most comprehensive environmental protection programs in European infrastructure history. During dredging, silt curtains, huge underwater barriers, are used to prevent fine particles from spreading and clouding the water. Continuous monitoring tracks oxygen levels, noise, and water clarity. If thresholds are exceeded, work must stop immediately. Noise pollution is another major issue. The pile driving and machinery required to build the tunnel can disorient marine mammals. To mitigate this, underwater noise is carefully measured and construction pauses during sensitive breeding periods. Denmark has even committed to creating artificial reefs nearby to replace habitats temporarily lost to dredging. Still, not everyone is convinced. Environmental lawsuits delayed the German side for years, forcing engineers to modify designs, add mitigation zones, and guarantee the project's compliance with EU Natura 2000 regulations. In the end, the courts ruled in favor of the project, but the debate over whether green megaprojects can truly be sustainable continues. Beyond the environmental sphere, the tunnel represents one of Europe's strongest examples of cross-border cooperation. Denmark finances most of the construction through state-backed loans, expecting to recover the costs from tolls and railway charges over several decades. Germany, meanwhile, invests heavily in upgrading its rail and road connections leading to the tunnel, ensuring both sides can handle the new traffic flows. The European Union also plays a key role, providing over 1 billion euros in funding through the Connecting Europe facility. For Brussels, this project isn't just about infrastructure, it's about integration. By linking the Nordic countries directly with Central Europe, the Fehmarnbelt Tunnel strengthens the economic spine of the continent and supports the EU's climate goals by promoting high-speed rail over air travel and ferries. In many ways, the tunnel symbolizes modern Europe itself, complex, negotiated, and constantly balancing ambition with accountability. Once operational, the Fehmarnbelt Tunnel will completely reshape the way Northern Europe moves. A journey that once required nearly an hour by ferry will soon take only minutes. The train connection between Copenhagen and Hamburg, which today takes around 5 hours, will be reduced to just 2.5. That single change could redefine business, tourism, and even daily life between Scandinavia and Central Europe. Experts estimate that the tunnel will serve around 10 million passengers and 3 million vehicles every year. For freight transport, the benefits are even greater. Instead of relying on ferries or lengthy detours through Jutland, trains will cross the Baltic directly, cutting travel time and reducing fuel consumption. This makes the tunnel not only a transportation project, but also an important step toward cleaner and more sustainable logistics across Europe. Economically, Denmark expects to recover the enormous investment within a few decades. During construction, more than 3,000 people have been employed directly, and thousands more have benefited indirectly through supply chains and subcontracting. The tunnel factory in Rødbyhavn has become a city of its own, a hub of innovation where engineers, technicians, and environmental specialists from all over Europe work side by side to create something unprecedented. For travelers, the experience will feel futuristic. Imagine boarding a train in Copenhagen, and before you've even finished your morning coffee, arriving on German soil without ever seeing the waves of the Baltic above you. Cars will pass through a brightly lit tunnel monitored by intelligent traffic systems with emergency response units ready at all times. Every aspect of the design, from the air ventilation to the color of the lighting, has been carefully considered to make the journey safe, efficient, and almost effortless. Of course, not everyone is convinced. Critics argue that toll revenues may not cover maintenance costs in the long run, or that the optimistic traffic forecasts could fall short. Environmental organizations continue to watch closely, ensuring that the marine ecosystem of the Baltic remains protected. Yet despite the debates and doubts, construction continues, and with every completed tunnel segment, Europe moves closer to realizing this historic connection.